Have you ever thought about what it would be like to have a career at NASA? What do you think you would be doing? This year, COSI is partnering with NASA to highlight some of the many different career paths available. Join us as we hear from experts who are willing to share a little bit about their careers with us.
Shoot for the moon. Even if you miss, you'll land among the stars. That's a quote by Les Brown, and it's one of my favorites, and it truly captures the essence of my journey to NASA. At a young age, I had dreamed of working at NASA. I always wanted to be an astronaut and travel to the moon like the Apollo 11 crew behind me, Neil Armstrong, Mike Collins, and Buzz Aldrin. Additionally, I grew up during the shuttle era, and I had dreamed of being able to catch a ride on the shuttle and be able to perform experiments on the International Space Station. Being an astronaut was my moon I was shooting for. In high school, I learned about internships and I had the opportunity to intern at NASA Glenn. It was there that my eyes were opened to the world of NASA, where there's much more than just astronauts and rockets. It was during my time there as an intern in high school, and I did two additional internships in college, where I learned and fell in love with that first A in NASA, aeronautics. That was my landing among the stars moment. During my internships, I helped build up turbo machinery facilities for testing state-of-the-art compressors and turbines for jet engines. Now, I may have lost you at, well, what's a compressor and turbine for jet engines and turbo machinery? Well, no worries, let me explain. Jet engines are very powerful machines that allow an airplane to stay and travel through the air. To look at a jet engine and understand how it works, we're first gonna look at a balloon. A balloon is a simple propulsion device. Think about it. I filled up a bunch of air in this balloon, and what happens if I release this nozzle? The balloon travels everywhere. Well, think of a jet engine as a very powerful and controlled balloon. So here, back to our example of a balloon. When I start to blow up the balloon, that is like the front part of a jet engine, and typically what you would see if you see aircraft, you see the fan, and the fan is what sucks and pulls that air into the engine. Now, some of that engine will go into the core of the engine, which starts with the compressor, and the compressor is made up of a series of rotating and stationary blades that continue to pull air and starts to pressurize it. As you go down the engine, these blades will get smaller, so it's taking all that air and building up more pressure. So that's like me blowing this balloon and continue putting more air into it. So as I blew up this balloon, this balloon's getting bigger, I'm putting more pressure onto the walls of this balloon. This air wants to escape. Now in an engine, we want to put more energy into the air. So it goes through a combustor. Next comes the fun part, the turbines. The turbine in an engine is the way that we're controlling releasing the air from this balloon. A turbine is made up of stationary and rotating blades, and they're constructed in such a way that it's extracting the energy from all that air. And that's what drives your fan and compressor. And then the air will go out the nozzle or the exhaust in the engine, providing you a little bit of thrust. So there you go. Now you understand how a jet engine works. I started working at NASA right after graduating college from studying mechanical engineering. From then, I've had the broad experience in the turbo machinery field, which is the study of jet engine components. I started off as a mechanical test engineer, and then I went on to become an aerospace research engineer studying turbine blades. Now the turbine section is very hot, so we must look at ways to not only protect the blade from melting, but also find ways to make those blades more efficient. After that, I joined the icing branch, where I led NASA's engine icing research. It was there that I worked in a facility that could test small, full-scale engines and learn about what would happen when these engines would fly through an ice cloud. The data is used to keep these engines safe when we fly. Today, I work in the Aeronautics Program Office, where I develop and help manage research projects. The thing I enjoy most about working in aeronautics is how I'm impacting the way you and I fly. The work we're doing in aeronautics is pushing the envelope. So what is possible? The aircraft today will continue to evolve and look much different in the future. Just imagine being able to fly across country in just half the time on a supersonic aircraft, or traveling in a plane that's running on electric propulsion. Or another idea, instead of catching that Uber or taxi to go across town, you can hop on a small aircraft instead. These are all concepts that NASA is thinking about and is doing research in to tackle those technical challenges to make the concepts a reality. So I'd like to leave you with one final quote, and it's a favorite of mine by Thomas Edison. Many of life's failures are people who did not realize how close they were to success when they gave up. So, see failures as a learning experience and keep going. Reach for the moon and land among the stars.
Thank you to the experts at NASA for sharing insight into their careers. And be sure to check out today's COSI Connects activity.